fun go?
Yeah, are you?
All this beauty.
Yes.
And there was a tour of the church.
Yale chapter, and we put out one trash bag.
No, not normally. I did some stuff for mass.
Thank you, Sarah. I'll send you.
Very bad.
Something like that. He wants to see like your shows. Maybe the city has no business having it, so.
I agree with that. You don't take tax dollars to talk to the bottom.
Yeah, I don't know how that worked out. I know I read the story.
Well, I read it once, I thought it was reading it.
That's great.
Because you want to process and stuff. Yeah, you're going to be $25 million on the assets. That's a very good.
Yes.
If I don't have one.
Right. Get it for $50. Tax, by the way, you did, it doesn't spell on here.
Yes, yeah.
We see you.
I see you too.
What do you think you're hiding from?
What are you doing right there?
Oh my God, I'm so glad.
That'll be a real thing. So,
Yeah.
Thank you.
pleasant surprise.
Oh my gosh.
Very nice. Glad it came up.
Yeah, if I'm elected, you know what you're to our community that's love, that loves God and listens to his word. So I'd like to start my little speech out tonight with a moment of silence to remember our guys in harm's way that's defending us all around the world, and the ones that have died, that's given up their freedom, so we can enjoy this evening tonight. So if you'll share a moment of silence.
Today we have over
7,500 doctors. 7,500 doctors, it gives well over $10 million worth of, and I may be wrong with the numbers, but $10 million worth of free medical treatment that our government is not burdened with. You know how that is when government isn't burdened. Secondly, that they're more available, more readily available when the veteran needs it. You know, it's a terrible thing to have a chiropractor appointment and not need it. You know what I mean? I needed it yesterday. Where was it yesterday? You know, I couldn't get out of bed today. I feel okay. But to have it right there in your own backyard, in your own communities, you know, I want to support him and his efforts because it has. Every time, again, I don't lend my name to much, but I'm proud to represent this patriot that can't do enough for our veterans. So thank you, Dr. The second issue that I'd like to bring up to you is commend you on your ability and your willingness to help your own community. I sit on the board with Woody Williams, who's a Medal of Honor recipient, the last one alive that served in Iwo Jima. He's 93 years old, he's about my size, and he's got more energy than I do, so I always look up to him, you know. But he's had some involvement throughout his career and his life where he felt the need to thank and remember the Gold Star families. So when we recognize the Gold Star mothers, as we should, because they've given the most in, you know, when they lost their son or their husband or whatever. So he started an initiative to have the Gold Star Family Memorial developed. And the purpose behind it is community service and reflection and help healing, start the healing process for those individuals. And every visit I've ever been with, every town I've ever been with, after we've dedicated and been back to support it, it's a tremendous beacon of light for those families. They have new, renewed conviction. They know the communities care about them, that they would go out of their way. I don't care about bricks and mortar. You know, I've been in real estate too. But the whole issue is this has got nothing to do with the bricks and mortar. It's symbolic of the healing process. And to bring a family in that understands, he may have all kinds of problems dealing with the city council, but the minute he can go and feel like the city council has approved and appreciated him and his family for the service of this great community, it eliminates all the barriers and helps the communication. And I've reached out after we first got started in that, wanting to have a real life evaluation. Everything comes back positive. All the families appreciate the efforts that the cities do and the communities do to help embrace them with their challenges and embrace them with a positive attitude of thankfulness. So I commend you on your ability and desire to build I drove by the park, it's a beautiful setting. I think it'll be a tremendous asset for you. And I think in years to come, you'll see the benefits of that decision you're making. So I thank you for that. So I applaud you for that, and I want to sit down for us. Sorry, I fall down. But anyway, thank you very much for having me.
Thank you.
Executive session minutes,
January 22nd, 2018. Special Committee of the Whole Meeting Minutes, January 22nd, 2018. Council Meeting Minutes, January 22nd, 18. Committee of the Whole Meeting Minutes, February 5th, 2018. Financial Reports, January 2018. And a new liquor license for GS Shira LLC at 550 North Main Street.
And Mr. President, just for the record, Member Fonte indicated to me to place on the record he wishes to abstain on the very last item only, the new liquor license.
Motion to approve as presented.
Second.
Foles?
Yes.
Fonte?
Yes.
Keithley?
Yes.
Peters?
Yes.
Revolt?
Yes.
Waring?
Yes.
And Saredd?
Yes.
Seven yes to approve the reports and requests.
All right, thank you very much. At this time, if you wish to address council, please step forward, state your name and address.
Melanie J. Rowe, 308 40 Street, Northwest. I would like to begin this evening by reading the meaning of dissent as described in the Oxford Dictionary. Dissent, the holding or expression of opinions at variance with those commonly or officially held. You have asserted that I am against government. That narrative is false. Actually, I am a proponent of government, and that includes the federal government, the state government, and the local government. At the federal level, there has been landmark legislation in my lifetime. One is the Voting Rights Act of 1965. Along with that legislation, there were rallies, marches, dissent. In January of 2017, folks took to the streets to protest the current president with rallies, marches, dissent, and all reported by the Free Press. At the state level, the Ohio Secretary of State has taken an aggressive attempt to purge the state's voter records. If one has not voted in a four-year period, your name could be purged. We should all be alarmed at this practice. Again, the right to vote, fundamental to our democracy. And rallies were held outside the Supreme Court during oral arguments. Again, dissent. The state legislature has crafted a May ballot issue to allow for a new map for congressional seats to be drawn after the 2020 census. Would that happen if citizens had not initiated signature gathering for redistricting? Probably not. And we happen to have someone in the audience, a citizen who helped with that signature gathering. At the local level, you are annoyed at people that express their views at public speaks. This is our dissent. You are further annoyed at having to express your opinion at what's coming before this body at the reports section of the meetings. And perhaps it's time to consider, are you suited for public office? Those of us who come to City Hall each Monday and listen to the 12 of you do so because we want to know what government is doing or not doing in the community where we reside. I have three short comments on the Water Board. The first is there are too many parallels between the CRA program and Northbridge. Second, if I had not gotten up here and asked repeatedly about whether the Water Board was going to meet or hadn't met, I don't think that I would have gotten that phone call of last December's meeting. And third, and most important, I think the city is foregoing an opportunity to annex a property that sits at our western doorstep. And with that comes jobs and income tax revenue. In conclusion, I will continue to speak in this public forum on issues that could impact Narcan's citizens. I will attempt to abide by the 5-minute rule, and I will do so in a civil manner. And that should be the objective of us all. For those of you who have listened, there is a thread through these remarks, and that thread is voting rights and dissent, two pillars of government and democracy. Thank you.
Thank you, Yvonne.
Chuck Osmond, 307 Fairview Street, Southeast North Canton, Ohio. I would like to speak to ordinance number 10-2018 that is on your legislative agenda tonight. The proposed ordinance is titled as an industrial and commercial occupancy grant agreement by and between the City of North Canton and Children's Hospital Medical Center of Nevada. Sadly, the legislation simply makes North Canton City Government a participant in the manipulation of its income tax policy to structure a contrived donation by Akron Children's Hospital that will take advantage of tax laws that benefit Children's Hospital. And these tax benefits that the hospital will gain with the active participation of North Canton City officials will come about on the backs of the hospital's employees through their payment of North Canton City income taxes. Is this laundering of tax dollars really needed? City officials always defend their corporate charity by saying the particular entity could choose to locate elsewhere. Not likely this time, and I will tell you why. In a May 2nd, 2013 repository story titled Stark Facilities Team Up with Akron Children's Hospital, the story reports that, and I quote, Altman had signed a letter of intent for Akron Children's to operate the inpatient pediatric unit at Altman. That was nearly 5 years ago. The 2013 story goes on to say, and I quote, for the last 5 years, Altman has collaborated with Akron Children's to operate the inpatient pediatric unit at Altman. Akron Children's Hospital and Altman Hospital have collaborated for 10 years at this North Canton location. And your argument is that tax incentives are needed to keep Children's Hospital from going elsewhere. I think you as members of City Council and the Health Administration should explain yourselves and say why you are playing musical chairs with North Canton income tax receipts. So it is your intention to collect income taxes from the employees of Children's Hospital and then return those income tax dollars back to the hospital. And out of the goodness of their corporate profit-motivated heart, Children's Hospital will donate $250,000, a portion of the returned income taxes, toward the upgrade of facilities at Dogwood Park. The $250,000 is and was already the city's tax dollars collected from hospital employees. And from this contrived donation of income tax dollars paid by hospital employees, Children's Hospital can realize tax benefits and garner undeserved PR. The moving of income tax dollars from Akron Children's Hospital employees, then to the city's coffers, then returning those same collected tax dollars back to Children's Hospital for them to return those tax dollars back to the city under the guise of a donation reminds me of those stupid shell games at the carnival. If one looks up the definition of shell game on a site called the Free Dictionary, one would find the following. One, a game in which an object is placed under one of three cups or shells, which are then moved around. The person playing the game must guess the final location of the object. The second definition of the game sums up what is taking place with this legislation. By extension, a method of deception that involves hiding or obscuring the truth. This legislation is nothing but a play on an old confidence trick by pretending to change things or pretending to change things that will afford tax breaks for Akron Children's Hospital. Explain the movement of the money to an adult or even a child, and both will look at you and wonder if you are either out of your head or an out-and-out crook. I would urge each of you, the next time you are up for re-election, to tell voters that this legislation was one of your proudest moments. When you perpetrated a fraud using city tax dollars, that you engaged in needless legislation to provide tax benefits to a corporation on the backs of the employees of that corporation. The nearly $1 million secret tax abatement for Northridge, the recent decision of the Water Board foregoing annexation of property expected to have 75 healthcare jobs, and now the manipulation of income tax policies from Rackham City Hospital does not bode well for the future of North Canton. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else wish to address council? Okay, we'll move on to new business. We have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 6-18.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say
aye. Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous vote of 7. An ordinance amending section 20 compensation of Jefferson 155 personnel regulations for 1 administrative code and codified ordinances of the state of North Canton to adjust the title and compensation of certain employees and declaring the same to be an emergency.
Thank you. A couple highlights. This removes the automatic Sunday overtime for part-time police, fire, and EMS dispatch. The positions listed in the schedule are to be advertised for a minimum of 2 weeks. And then once we get our legs underneath this as far as human resources, functions over in the finance department. We'll have a position description on file for each of these positions. So any questions? I entertain a motion and a second to adopt.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of 7.
Thank you. Motion and a second to suspend the rules of council.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of 7.
Thank you. Motion and second to adopt under suspension.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of 7.
All right, thank you. We have a motion and second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 7-18.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of 7. An ordinance amending ordinance number 100-2017, authorizing the mayor of the city of North Canton to enter into a contract binding between the city of North Canton and the city of Canton for the purpose of providing legal representation in the Canton Municipal Court for the prosecution of criminal cases by increasing the total cost not to exceed from $19,500 per year to $22,000 per year for a period of 2 years beginning January 1st, 2018 through December 31st, 2019, amending appropriations to cover the increased cost and declaring the same to be an emergency.
Thank you, Chairwoman Warren.
So we talked about this before. We talked about it in 2017 and now 18. The reason for this amendment is because the price went up by $500. And so we're just discussing here, providing more representation to the Canton Municipal Court for prosecution of criminal cases. And this is an emergency as well. And to adopt, and then we'll have questions.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of 7.
Thank you. Motion and second to suspend rules.
So moved. Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of 7.
Thank you. Finally, motion and second to adopt under suspension.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes have it unanimously. Please vote of seven.
Thank you. May I have a motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 8-18?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes have it unanimously. Please vote of seven. And ordinance authorizing the Director of Administration of the City of North Canton to advertise and receive bids on the specifications now on file in the Director's office and authorizing the mayor of the City of North Canton upon board of control approval to enter into an agreement for the purchase of two large cruisers from a vendor or in the alternative pursuant to the Ohio Department of Purchase Act, which one of these seems to be an emergency.
Thank you, Chair. What were?
This just allows the Director of Administration to advertise and receive bids on the purchase of two large cruisers. And we're going to put this in the budget, so. This is also an emergency. Any questions? We talked about this when we went through budget. Can we turn it off?
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes have it unanimously. Please vote of seven.
All right, motion and a second to suspend rules.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes have it unanimously. Please vote of seven.
Motion and a second to adopt.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes have it unanimously. Please vote of seven.
Thank you. Motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 9-18.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Please vote of six, yes, one abstain.
Thank you.
And ordinance authorizing the supplemental appropriation of funds of the City of North Canton to be appropriated from the unappropriated resources of the Fire Operating Fund to the miscellaneous grant expenditures account in the amount of $49,980 for the current expenses during the fiscal year ending 7/31/2018, and currently seem to be an emergency.
Thank you, Chair. What were?
Laura, you explained this last week, and it's just kind of reallocation from the fire fund to the miscellaneous grant expenditures account. Do you want to say anything else?
Sure. This is just appropriating the money that we received through grant. So at the beginning of the year, when we did the budget, we didn't know we received this. Now that the state's granted it to us, then we just have to turn around and appropriate it so the fire department can spend our grant. Yes, sir.
Mr. Peters?
Yes.
Would the record reflect that Member Keesler wishes to abstain on item 13, not item 12?
Didn't have our glasses on.
I'll make that adjustment.
Yeah.
There's glasses.
I got it.
Need a motion to adopt. So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes have it unanimously. Please vote of seven.
All right, motion and a second to suspend rules, Chair.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes have it unanimously. Please vote of seven.
All right, and motion and a second to adopt by suspension.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed?
Abstain.
The ayes have it unanimously. Please vote of seven.
Okay, motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of ordinance number 10-18.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Abstain.
Six ayes, one to abstain. And ordinance authorizing the mayor of the City of North Canton to enter into an industrial and commercial occupancy grant agreement by between the City of North Canton and Children's Hospital Medical Center of Akron Children's Hospital. And we turn this in to be an emergency.
I'll take that then. This is, we discussed this last week. This has been in the process now for almost a year. And it has come to a fantastic ending here. I want to thank, first of all, Pat and Deb Lane for kind of leading leading this thing, Lauren, Tim, Zion, all the council people who put some time into this. This will bring significant jobs, significant tax dollars to both our school and our city, and the significant parks project. So we're really looking forward to that. Any other discussion, any other comments?
No, we're excited for it.
Okay, I open up for a motion to approve.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed?
Abstain.
Voice vote of six yes means abstain.
Thank you. Motion is second to suspend rules of council.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed?
Abstain.
Voice vote of six yes means abstain.
Thank you. And finally, motion is second to adopt by suspension.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed?
Abstain.
Voice vote of six yes means abstain.
All right, thank you very much. Motion and a second to read by title only the first reading of resolution number 3-18.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of seven, a resolution authorizing the mayor of the city of North Canton to enter into a memorandum of understanding binding between the city of North Canton and the Gold Star Families Memorial Monument for Shoulder Reorders, Mellow Monument Foundation, for the purpose of constructing, erecting, and dedicating the Gold Star Families Memorial to the city of North Canton.
Thank you, Chairman Foltz.
Thank you.
As we heard tonight from Colonel Ballard, excellent presentation and discussion about what this means to families. And we're very fortunate to have it here in North Canton with Dr. Nadella's help and Councilman Serretta's help also, and administration and everybody else. If you look in the packet, we did, I think there were some clarifications or some other words used to, I think, address Governor Bolt's question about water. I think in item 9, city will relocate and will replace tree shrubbery and man-made structures that might interfere with monument's final placement. I'm hoping that was the intent, Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
Obviously, it's a great thing to have this done, and we're hoping for a July 7th dedication. So, will there be any other questions from the council on this regarding the language and mental understanding, memorandum of understanding?
Do you think the deadline could be by July? Can we have that project?
Well, we're working that deadline back, so we need weather to work with us. Councilman Strachey, do you have something else to add as far as the donation?
Yeah, I just heard this week that the Hughes concrete folks are going to donate the concrete, so that's what I need. People are, just like we expected, this is something that is really honorable for our community, and people are going to jump on board with it. Looking good. Yeah.
This is the only one in the state, right?
Correct. Yes. And,
that's a good honor.
Pucci's doing the labor work, so everybody, you're going to have more of this, I think, as we gain momentum towards the weather break, so. With that, I'll ask for a motion to approve.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of seven.
Thank you. Motion is second to suspend rules of council.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of seven.
Thank you. Finally, motion is second to adopt.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed? The ayes carried by unanimous voice vote of seven.
All right, thank you. Reports, Mayor Fuente, you're up.
Three quick things. Rob shot me a list of the streets. We have 18 streets on the 2018 group, and hopefully if there's any other ones that we need, we can maybe squeeze them in somehow. I'm sure there's some extra money laying around for that, right, Rob? The second thing is,
John, I'm going to stop there for a minute. Did we keep getting those on that?
Okay, well, I just got it, so right. I'll make sure to get it out to you.
Gotcha.
On what part of the rough draft list? It said 8 damn, so it was like 28.
It will probably grow once a week.
I got a feeling my ward definitely needs it.
Yeah. Yes.
Hey, so local businesses, if you haven't had a chance, stop out of Pabst, try some ice cream, stop at Mount Mazzardi's, check out our local businesses, make sure you invite your friends and family in, and support those local businesses, our business partners. And the third thing is, this is something I was just thinking, a couple of people brought up to me about whenever we have things on emergency, they think fire truck emergency, you know? So I'm just wondering if we need to put like a definition of what the emergencies are, what it really means. It's not like a fire truck emergency. And maybe sometimes Tim will explain one more time why we need things on emergency. That's all I have to report.
Thank you, Member Fleming. Member Ware.
Okay. Last Friday, I was honored to attend the Walsh University Joan Marlene Toot Center dedication. Doug, you were there as well. And it was really a neat building and such a nice dedication. Many people attend, a great community event. While I was there, Matthew Parker, who is the executive director for the Renisi Center for Civic Engagement, was there. And I think he's talked to you, Mark, he said, about possibly having a meeting there. And they have a kind of, was a very Greek kind of oriented, and they wanted to make an open space for people to come in. And he's going to have a class there. He's going to go audit if we'd like. And then people come in and leave and make comments, and it's just a really, really neat center. It's so nice to see what an important part of our community again that is, and just all the different things they're doing. And President Jusson was very pleased we were there, and it was just felt very good to be there. So I'm thankful for Walsh and all that they do and all of our jobs that they've created and quite a community also. I want to thank Mike Battershaw again. I think the last time that we had more snow, we had more mailboxes that went down, and Mike's person stopped, like the woman came out, and it happens at the end of a run. And so I really, and the way our mailboxes are hung, they're hung with two pegs, and the snow just shoves up. It's not like they're being careless and knocking them down, or it's the snow really so much it knocks it over. And he couldn't have been nicer and more polite and hospitable. And you know, we talk about that, customer service. And so thanks to Mike's guys for doing that. And then Mike answered emails from two of the residents in this area very quickly and timely. And I just want to say thanks. It's been a long winter for people. And this was the day that snowstorm hit at like 4 in the morning. All the schools were legitimately closed right that day. And so that was big. And then one last thing. For Leadership Start County, we had our education day this week, and I was able to be at Orchard Hill and Hoover High School, and superintendent spoke, assistant superintendent, principals, and they just rolled out the red carpet for us, and we had 5 different schools throughout the area, but just how fortunate we are to have these schools in our community. But Orchard Hill, oh my gosh, just what they're doing there as a goal, was it a new star? Mark, I saw your wife, Lori. Blue Ribbon School. Just the things they're doing and accomplishing. It's an amazing asset that we have with our schools. So that was it. Good week.
Keesling.
I'm excited to say we have a new business coming into town on Schneider Street down my area. They're taking over that warehouse. It's called, facility is called FIT Company, FIT, Frame, Inspire, Transform. They actually got a small business loan, as well, so can't wait to see that.
Yeah, absolutely. Member Ball. I think that we're going to have public policy issues where we are going to have legitimate concerns. And we heard tonight from Chuck about this particular economic model project. And I guess I'd like to have read into the record the observation of one of my former colleagues with 25 years of economic development experience. I called him tonight because I was interested in what the state's job creation tax credit was. See, you know, just want to find out what I checked if you're online. And my colleague called this particular project perfect. Perfect. And I think it's perfect because, and it's a good label, because Pat and Mark did a great job moving this through over a year. They worked with the development board, they worked with the chamber as a team effort. They assembled, frankly, a very reasonable incentive package. Pat issued a commitment letter. that define the project and the incentives. And I think what's been lost in some of this discussion is that the city was mindful of one of our most important constituents, our school system. The fact of the matter is the school received roughly $160,000 a year, correct, when this building is completed. Economic development, in many ways, is like playing poker, where you don't know what the opposing opponent has in his hands. If you were to go to a site selection list, there are usually 10 criteria, form them down. State and local taxes is always one of them. And I know Chuck and I have had some conversations about this. And first of all, I would say this, is that Chuck is reflecting a school that does exist in economic development. It's the No Incentive School. And trust me, it does have very prominent proponents. But unfortunately, when you have an opportunity, sometimes you don't have the luxury of waiting. And so for a very, very modest cost, roughly $257,000 in deferred income tax, that school is going to collect $167,000 a year. And I know that Jeff and I had the privilege of sitting in the superintendent's ad hoc finance committee meetings. That school needs revenue. And this project goes a small way to delivering a very significant chunk of money to that school system. What was the cut on the city's cut on the property tax, which we did not pay? In year one, 100%, it's 41.2, and we're gonna put 31 on property. 21. Sorry, that's not bad. That's not a bad exchange. And again, when you look at the big picture and what the schools are gonna receive out of this, I think all of us would agree that's a pretty good deal. Definitely. You know, economic development is perfect. I tell you, I've been around a lot of bad deals in my short career, but this is a pretty good one. And it's defensible on any number of fronts. Again, I come back to what my colleague said. This was perfect. 200 feet across the street is basically a tax-free zone. Income tax rezone. And if income tax doesn't matter, if you don't think it matters, it matters. Watch what happens in Canton. It is going to be something, it may be something to behold. So again, I come back to the job that our team did, Patrick, Mark, maxed out my world with the numbers, Doug, Ray Hexler. We have a project today. We don't have to wait for it. It's here. And I think that is, in the end, that's a pretty critical development. We're not waiting for some small development. We have one that's quite substantial. So, that's my long report.
All set.
Thank you. Perfect.
That
was not
long.
No, perfect, Mr. Spratt. Perfect.
Mr.
Diorio. Perfect.
Thank you for those kind of words, actually. But I think more than anything, we want people to know that our arms are open. We want your businesses here. And we will look at new ways to get it here if it's good for everybody. This just happened to be win-win-win-win. We want it to be that way. So that's a note there. But we're ready for it. Come on in.
I would add one final comment. This goes to developments earlier state. I think it's absolutely critical that we do have constituents who look at this. I was in a meeting today. And my comment was, it's got to pass public muster. It has to pass public muster. Are we going to have disagreements? The answer is yes, we are. But I think if we go into this and we're prudent as best we can be, I think we'll have a better outcome. But we need criticism. We should always be mindful. And I need criticism.
Talking good about criticism. Thank you.
Thank you.
A couple things here.
probably the last time we talked about this in your executive, but we did have the Christiana Lee Guard Shack. It was a nice little crowd, a lot of Heritage Society folks there. It was like freezing. So Pat did a nice job of having the city crew kind of plow away so we can have the nice end. It was a nice little event, and it was on that day because that was the actual day 100 years ago that it became, New Berlin became our camp. So that was very nice that those folks had that. We do have a water board meeting on Wednesday. At Wednesday morning, 9 o'clock, we'll be in the fishbowl over there. We have a few people that want our water and a few folks that need some help because they had too much excess water somehow. So we'll be discussing those items.
I was just wondering, like, if we sell water outside that's not annexed in, could we benefit as citizens that pay taxes to get a discount on our water rates? You know, like, if we ever do sell outside, the benefit would come back to the citizens that pay taxes that we get a slight discount.
Yeah, apparently we do.
The more we sell, the more or less we get.
You will, in the matter of, the more we sell outside, we won't have to raise rates on inside.
I didn't know where that was, and so it's my bills a lot more lately. And I don't know if that's good, it's my son's native long shower.
Go to water.
We have a conflict.
That's all I have. Thanks.
Thank you.
Member Foltz.
Thank you. I'm from Calvary Road. Appreciate your voting rights and dissent discussion. It's very good. I hope she's still here again.
She's back.
Okay. And I always appreciate when people come up, even with a different point of view, that are civil, and that's what this is about, you know. Not to act any other way with that. We try to run a good forum here. It's reflective of our community. Thank you for that. Another consideration, Pat's hard work, everybody involved, is that $250,000 is going towards a park. You know, near and dear that is to everyone here, especially me. And when you think about that, we have hopefully state officials working on our behalf. And Pat put together that great presentation on all those capital improvements. And when you look at competitiveness for grant dollars, or even just state and local money, the more collaboration or partners you have, the better off you're going to be. Those are actual points on a grant criteria to go through and fill one out. So that's critical to say that this new group coming in the city is part of this project. And that's going to help us for other grant opportunities down the road. So that's, before North Canton used to be, we had money, we didn't apply for grants. Those days are gone. I applaud this administration and council to get behind more grant opportunities. I'm pretty successful in doing that in other places. I think we need to do that here. Win, as Mark says, win for the parks too. And to applaud our road department, our services there, snow plowing. We're known for it, but if you ever drove where I drove these streets at 5 in the morning, all throughout the town, townships and county, and it's just refreshing to know that we get wet pavement. You know where North Canton. We're known for it, and I applaud our workers. Make sure we tell them that during the meetings. And it's been a tough winter. It snows, a couple days later it's snowing again, and it's freezing rain, or it's iced up, and it's black ice. There's a lot going on out there. And to Donald's point, unfortunately, we're probably going to add some roads to that list that you're not even maybe considering right now once we get to spring. So hopefully we'll free up more money because it's going to happen.
Well, zero weather, the binding doesn't hold up in zero weather.
Right.
That's why it was like a disaster seven.
So those are my thoughts. Thank you.
Features.
Features.
Yeah, pickles and beets.
And thanks for that. I'll segue into this. I have two phone calls about some road issues. I just want to make you guys aware of it. This one has been ongoing for quite a while. On Weber, between Howard and Maple Northeast, ironically, right, all of my ward.
I believe that's the utility one.
It's right underneath that big tree. I'm not sure what kind of tree it is, but that big patch, that's a problem. So if we could get that looked at. Whitworth, next to the fire station, moving east, is horrible. I mean, you literally have to drive down the middle of that road. It's pretty bad. Orchard, you and I, Rob, talked about this. Northeast just
south of Fifth Street. Did you guys have a chance to go out there and look at those driveway?
Yes, we did.
All right, so that plan.
That was planned for that.
And lastly, 7th Street, right almost in front of Dogwood Shelter, we have a big crater starting to create, and buses coming up and down there are making that worse. I don't know if you guys have seen that, but basketball games and whatnot, it's highly traveled, so get someone out there to fill that in, it's getting bad. And I've noticed it getting worse over the last couple of days. So, and that's it. It's all set for the board, but no apologies. Director Flores.
Yes, sir. Member Revolt very clearly and eloquently explained the economic development opportunity that's available to us. So there's really no way to address that other than perhaps a technical aspect in that this evening it was challenged and called a shell meeting. Essentially called council and anyone established or involved with this a bunch of charlatans. But what I wish to point out is that this economic development program is state sponsored. It's a state statute. And it's been in effect for over 25 years. So to that extent, if you feel that it's some sort of shenanigans that goes on to promote economic development, your argument is not with North Canton. It's taking advantage of program when it believes it's appropriate and in the city's best interest. If you wish to prevent this program from continuing, your argument is General Assembly, State of Ohio. That's why.
Thank you, sir. Director Finance.
Thank you. Just wanted to give an update on the website project. It's been a while since we've talked about that, but we are quickly coming towards the deadline for our new site to go live. That should happen towards the end of March. The first full week of March, we'll have our training. We have a 3-day web-based training with the company that's helping us develop that. I've invited Georgia Council to that, as well as someone from administration, and then Shannon and myself, and we'll go through all features of the site. I think there's a lot of things we'll really be able to use, such as email blasts. We can alert people of things if they want to sign up for meeting notices, minutes, agendas. The calendar will work much better. There is something Mr. Fonte will like, which is a business directory we can set up over the long term, you know, start building things like that through the website, so I think it'll be very nice. Over the next 2 weeks, if anyone goes on our site and you see things that are missing or broken, that's intentional. We're trying to pull the bad information off before we move over to the good.
Laura, on the directional mics, when can we expect to have those in place?
Those have been ordered. There's a couple of parts that are back ordered on mics of what we need hooked into the system. So as soon as that comes off back order, we'll have those.
Thank you.
That's all I have.
All right, thank you, Director of Administration.
Yes, before I go over a couple items that I have in mind for this, just to comment on a few of the things that were discussed here in relation to snow plowing. And you know, it's not something that's widely known, but just to let you know the challenges that we face or other communities face as well. That you know, when it comes in relation to filling those holes that are created, which you also talked about. And previously, we were able to get you know, hot patch available from a nearby distributor, and we were, you know, I guess everybody was notified a few weeks back that they shut their doors. They're not making any more patch. So if you want patch, you got to drive to Kent, get it, move it into one truck a day. And by the time he gets back, it's not so hot anymore. It's cold. So sometimes it seems futile where someone's in the sand in the ocean by putting the patch in, but you know, if it gives us relief for a couple of days until we're able to get into some better weather where the temperature is going to hold. So just want you to be aware of that. Then, you know, Mr. Battershaw is working very diligently at it, just to ensure other communities are as well. We're fortunate we don't have as many roadway miles as some of you.
Yeah, I have a quick question. Are there weather restrictions using our Durapatcher?
The Durapatcher is not, yes, we don't want to insert that way. It's not optimal in these types of conditions.
Is that the same as the hot box?
Yep.
What's the cost of a patch board?
I'm sorry, the cost of?
What's the cost of a patch board?
Of a patch what?
Plants.
For time, is that true?
No.
If we had a.
Let's say we could form alliance with Lake, Plain, Jackson. Maybe Canton. And maybe get somebody like Dick Kaiser to host it. Pay for it. Is it feasible? I don't know. Maybe running a Kent isn't very.
It's unusual that we, you know, it's the first time that we've had to do it. I just want to make mention of it. You know, I suspect that the market conditions will change and someone will step in and avoid it to do that. But it's something worth talking to our neighbors about.
Okay.
I know our neighbors have been calling us regarding the next item on our agenda. Is, do you have any salt you can sell us?
Right.
Because also, and our, I'm sure residents feel our fair share of snow, and the north of us, even that Cleveland area, there was a period there where it snowed every day for 23 days.
Wow.
And trucks are being limited as to how much salt they're willing to sell you. And we were allowed two trucks per community. And those communities have a higher priority than the ones here. So that's why we're seeing some of those townships that you just mentioned that run out of salt and they don't have any place to go. You know, fortunately, our salt bins filled to the gills, and I think everybody, you know, around knows that. We should note that, you know, we've worked our way probably 2/3 of the way through that salt pot. And we figure how many salt events we might have before we get to spring. And I think we calculated it to be around 15 or so, you know, snow events that we would want to drop salt on. So you were praying for, you know, some relief from the weather, giving us a chance to get caught up on that. But just so that you know, salt is very restricted, as is the asphalt this time.
We can barter salt for asphalt. A little bit of salt.
Okay. We did have a meeting, I'm sure all of you are aware of it, but just for the sake of saying it, since this is our first council meeting, we'd like to do a report. Since we had the meeting with the AEP folks, Councilman Peters and Councilmember Warren, we had some of their constituents come in and talk about what this American Electric Power upgrade means to them, timetables to get it done, that type of thing. It's about a year-long project. Residents asked lots of questions. They were all answered. I think the result was they all felt very good when they left. That the city was concerned about the aesthetics. We've taken steps to address some of the aesthetics on a permanent basis that makes it more palatable in the neighborhoods, doesn't stand out as much. So just let you be aware of that.
And thank you for doing that, organizing that. And I thought AEP just did a great job. Really weren't a club of people, but to have Mr. Wheeler out there and then to have the five of them out there giving information, it certainly made those around the area feel a lot better. So thank you.
Yeah, and the fact that they were able to actually touch something to the fencing, that was outstanding.
We know the fencing.
FYI, for those of you who, you know, ever wanted to attend the competitive bid submission at the opening but didn't find time in your agenda to do so, there was a change in the Ohio Revised Code that we were notified of that says that materials submitted to a public office in response to a competitive solicitation should not be considered public records for purposes of this section until the date the public office announces the award of a contract based on the solicitation. So you know, before when we would open up bids, we spread them out around the table and then everybody kind of come up and look at them and then, but because of the changes in the law, we were notified by Columbus that that practice is not allowed anymore. So after the bid is awarded, then we're able to make those documents available. Just FYI. There was an inquiry this week about the traffic light at the intersection at Whipple and Glenwood. As it turns out, that traffic light is not in the city, that is a county light, and there was some issues with it. We went ahead at the request of the Councilman Fonte, who notified us of it, to let the county know, and they promptly dispatched the crews out there to take care of that and get it addressed. We went ahead and then just prepared a list. Didn't know if you wanted me to email it to any of you of the intersections that belong to the city of North Canton, the intersections that belong to the county. There's an intersection that also belongs to the state. So if you ever wanted that, we kind of have that available. I can email it to those that to all of you can do with it as you see fit. In conjunction with the finance department and the website development, building department under the leadership of John Stagall is moving forward with a public access module so that the builders or the people who are pulling permits or these kinds of things will be able to integrate and get access to these through our website and fill them out, make it a lot quicker, and email those documents to us. We were unable to do that before because we didn't have the software in-house. From a building department standpoint, let alone the website. Your interesting tidbit information that the VIA recently published the report of the 2017 housing permits for Stark County by subdivision. And North Canton had 26 housing permits pool for the 2017, which I thought was really good, considering that the landlocked, mostly built out. As comparison, Jackson Township had 112, Lake Township had 46, so you'd expect those areas to be ahead. The city of Canton had 11. The Stark County Health Department is holding their annual District Advisory Council meeting on Thursday, March 1st at their headquarters at Convenience Circle. This is something that we are required to attend. The mayor has asked me to attend in his stead, which is permitted under the rules, but for those of you that would like to attend, FYI. The Ohio Municipal League, this affects all of you. Is once again asking for your assistance, as in the past, during even numbered years, the Ohio Municipal League conducts seminars for elected council members after the municipal election year. These seminars are held regionally and on Saturdays for convenience. So we have a list of locations. I'll forward that over to the clerk's office, but for those of you who didn't attend one for a long time, this would be a good opportunity to refresh yourselves on that. And the list goes on, doesn't it? Just if you give me the microphone and just let me.
I really, 2 weeks
since I got to the report. That's a lot that builds up. Did you see the editorial in the Plain Dealer on January 28th? It posted a very strongly worded editorial, one of the strongest I've seen, about they recommend that Mayor's Courts in Ohio should be abolished. Thought that was interesting, and they gave a lot of reasons why, but we are well ahead of the game.
Hey, Pat, I just want to say thanks for taking care of that traffic light. There was basically a doctor on his way to the emergency, and he's been running into problems, so he felt bad he had to run through the light. And this was like at 10:30 on Saturday night, was it? And I said it to you, you responded like that, so I say thank you.
Yeah, quite welcome. We have a great team. Not only did John Hawkins Smith respond to that, Rob Graham responded to this to me.
I know, it was awesome.
They were right out.
That's what I like, not 9-to-5ers.
Just two final things. One is that we did have a pre-construction meeting regarding the portico. You remember the portico?
Oh, so well.
Yes, so well. So we opted to do a spring start on that. We're looking to start the first week of March, so about 2 weeks. So we assemble all the team together to start talking about how we're going to lay this out. There's some things that our employees are going to do ahead of that to kind of prepare that site and get them ready so that they can get in, do the work, and get out. The timetable for construction starting in the beginning of March, if all goes well, we would finish around Mother's Day, so mid-May. And we're hoping that for the Memorial Day Parade, we have a grand opening, and that we can use the facility as a viewing area for the parade. It'll work out real well. They'll be taking some precautions during this time. We will be boarding up the windows in the front of City Hall because the cement that's going to be mounted may have to be jackhammered or lifted out, and just so that they don't damage any of the windows in that respect. So those of you who might be driving by City Hall and see that happen in the next few weeks, you can
see the Marlins across the street.
Yeah, man. Go ahead. We'll look
like the
hood.
I'm sorry, no. I didn't know that.
Just through the softball.
Hey, it's a real lot.
So I'll keep you advised of those developments. And finally, just it was a fun moment last week on Friday when we shared this with Councilman Peters. We had a little talk about there was a group of grade schoolers, middle schoolers, from North Canton here at the building, 15 to 20 of them in all. They were doing a community service visit, and they were here to see the real heroes of our community, police department, fire department, and I didn't want to leave out us. After they had their police department, I asked them if they wouldn't like to come upstairs and dangle out the carrot that they can see the mayor's office, but I really wanted to be able to come in here. So. Came up, brought them in here. This is City Council. This is what you know what a City Council does. And we try to make it an interactive, educational kind of thing. And it just the kids were really into it. And so on the spur of the moment, I just said, well, how would you like to hold a mock council meeting? And just go on up there and sit at the dais, grab a seat, and you be the person behind whose name the place you're sitting. And they were a little confused at first, thinking that this was a court of law and a city council meeting. We kept getting objections to the overrule and all that kind of stuff. But once they got into it, I thought it would be good to then just present an issue to the community that they could talk about, get their opinions on. So the issue, and I chose the role of being the concerned citizen and bringing the issue up to the forum, started the meeting. Visitors were permitted. I came up and spoke about community cats and explained the problem with community cats, and it was something that was eye-opening to them. And did not think of that these are the types of problems we have to deal with. And then I just went around with them and said, well, Councilman Peters, I live in Ward 2 and I'm concerned about these cats and how would you want to address it? And then as they answered it, then I pulled somebody else in, and it was just a gas. Laura was here to help with it. It was a lot of fun. So I mentioned this to Councilman Peters, and he had a great idea of why don't we, as time goes on, we talk to our contacts at the school and see if that's something that they would want to do once a year as part of the government. Community service plan or whatever it is, but there actually be a real one where we can help them with an agenda and give them an opportunity to see what's going on. So I want to thank the Peters for that because I'm one of the most gracious.
Yeah, on my full plan.
Great.
Yeah.
I was wondering why I had gum on my chair.
And who wants to love the machine?
Or are they going to take some pause?
story can be found on our Facebook page. It's a great coach.
That's nice.
And they really like the gal.
So do I.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ben.
Very good. Yes, you know, it's as I'm listening to the council meeting tonight, there's so many positive things going on in the city. And when I think back to like the days back in 2006, 2007, 2008, when we were on the receiving end of a lot of bad business, a lot of bad circumstances, it was just a tough, tough time. And most all of you were in that room at the same time. I think our seating actually even changed too. I think, you know, administration's over on this side of the room. But you know, I think it really reflects the transformation that the city's gone through. And you can see how we handle conflict now in the city with the employees, within the administration, within our various departments, within our council. There's plenty of conflict, but everybody's embracing the conflict. And we serve to, you know, refine each other in those arguments, in those positions. Whether we're talking about bringing Akron Children's here, or the Gold Star Memorial, or replacing the water lines with the county. I mean, there's all these different challenges that we have, and it's just great to see everybody working together. It really is nice. I mean, I think our word for the, you know, the year is collaboration. Because we're so much more effective when we embrace the conflict and when we're collaborating with each other. There's so much less energy that we spend, and we're getting so much more success. So we have communities that are struggling to keep businesses in, and we're bringing in new businesses right now. But I think we've learned a lot over the years. When I look back at myself, the decisions that we made back 10, 12 years ago, we would not take the same approach we're taking now, because we've learned a lot. So I appreciate everything that, you know, Mark Serretta, Patrick DiOrio, Laura Brown, on the Children's Hospital, also Doug Lane. I mean, that was a year in the making. And Councilmember Volk, you couldn't have stated it any better. I mean, what a great success. And then I also want to congratulate Doug Fultz. We're going to be able to spread our wisdom and Department of Recreation on down at the city of Canton. As Doug has accepted the position, the city of Canton, Park of Recreation, Park of Recreation Director of the city of Canton.
Where you go, front page?
Yes. Very nice.
Yeah. Woo. I love it.
Very nice.
Remember, keep that grand front coming here to North Canton first, and we'll be all right.
It might be a competition. Always 60-40, Doug. Always 60-40. We're going to have to collaborate on the grants.
Collaborate.
Yeah.
That's a good idea. We also have Judge Forshino. We talked about collaboration. He's headed up the heroin symposium that's going to be taking place on March 1st. It's called the Stop Wearing Heroin, from Killing Committee to provide answers for people that are struggling with drug addiction. It's a real, real serious problem. I had the opportunity to listen on YouTube the symposium that they had at Perry High School. I wasn't able to attend, but I heard such great things about it. I listened to it on YouTube. I'll tell you, anybody that is a parent, anybody that is a grandparent, if you listen to the presentation that was given at Perry High School by the nurse and the doctors that attended that, it was excellent. So I highly recommend it. So I'm sure that this symposium that we're going to have, which is March 1st, 6 to 8 p.m. at the Malone University Johnson Center, I'm sure that'll be a great program also. And then lastly, I mean, what more could we ask for to end off the evening? Congressional Medal of Honor recipient, Doc Fowler. I mean, here's a man that had jumped through himself on a hand grenade to save his fellow soldiers. Now,
When you think about service, somebody like him that is willing to give his life for other people, you can't ask for any other greater act of service or love than somebody like that. And the grenade didn't go off. And that's why he's still here. But for somebody who was willing to do that, that takes an incredible person. And so to have him here and have him come and honor us as elected officials is really, really inspiring to me. And so that brings me to the last item, which is the Gold Star Memorial. Another example of collaboration with the various sites. We looked at a number of different techniques as far as how to place it, where to place it, how to go about it, who's going to maintain it, how we're going to raise the money. That's coming together, and with Dr. Novelli and Doc Ballard, I really don't even know what else to say. It's just, it's brilliant. It's a good evening in the city. So I appreciate everybody's cooperation and more collaboration.
Thanks.
Outstanding. Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Mr. Chair. We opened bids for projects back on Friday, February 2nd in here. The first bid, both went real well. The first one was actually the rebid of our Eastwood tennis courts. That's the one we bid last year. We just had one bidder, and our bidder was like around $143,000. This year we had five bidders,
nice.
And we estimated $150,000. Our low price was $127,990.
Yes.
So we controlled beforehand tonight. We also opened the Price Park Storm Sewer Phase 2 bids. We have 11 bidders for that one.
Wow.
Not a huge number. And we get them out early. We had $250 in the budget and a cost estimate that our consultant was a little over $300,000 conservative. But our low bid was Central Allied Enterprises at $199,000.
Yes.
Could we take that extra money and throw it into the roads?
In order to?
Possibility of moving that council meeting into that week.
Yeah.
Okay.
Horns and stuff, right?
Yeah. Okay, good, thank you, I forgot to bring that up, I'll make a notation of that. All right, final call for the business. Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Adjourn.
Where could we?